want around, you know what I mean?
Lieutenant Colonel Bliss, this is Arthur Tran from Polliner New and Creative Associates. First, let me say what a pleasure it is to be working for a company like yours and with someone like you, so devoted to keeping our great country safe. I've sent you the storyboards for the proposal for your firm, which we're calling Island Thunder. It starts with a flyover by a wing of attack helicopters, all firing full blast. Behind them, there's a massive explosion, followed by a pan down to where we see one soldier in your company's uniform taking out a dozen enemies with a massive machine gun. Tasteful heavy metal, and a voiceover that emphasizes the sorts of awesome adventures your men have been on a day-to-day basis. Tell me what you think.
Mr. Tran, this is Charles Bliss calling. I just wanted to let you know that I got your message and I looked at your storyboard, and that your ad is the biggest piece of crap I've ever seen. And that includes the time I got trapped marching behind 16 elephants in a parade. You show no understanding of what my company is, what my people do, or what sort of high-character individuals we're looking to recruit. So, you have 1 week to do better, or I'll fire you, and we'll do better. Do I make myself understood? Bliss out.
Lieutenant Colonel Bliss, sir, first let me apologize for the previous effort we sent you. That was the work of a junior associate who has, of course, since been let go. We've assigned all of our senior staff to your project, and I think you'll be very pleased with the revisions. It's a very simple concept. Just you, talking about your service and the idea of loyalty and duty. And I think we can bring it in at well under your budget, so call me back and let me know.
This is Eva Acosta, urban spelunker extraordinaire. New York has been cordoned off by the government, and I am in the most exclusive club in the world, Manhattan. Thomas and Blanca got their asses caught by the JTF. Not me. But then they don't have my mad parkour skills. I'm exploring the city and reporting what I see, taking nothing but photos and leaving nothing but footprints, and maybe the occasional audio recording, so people know where I've been and the incredible things I've seen here. The adventure begins. This is Eva Acosta, urban spelunker, and this is my first night exploring the Big Apple. Gotta say, it's spooky as hell here. New York used to be a very crowded place, but it is creepy how quiet it is now. Hardly any lights, just the wind howling through the buildings. Can you hear that pack of dogs? Don't know if they have rabies or what, but I am keeping far away from them. It's a moonless night, and it's dark as hell. The streets are full of snowdrifts, and there is nothing moving anywhere. No traffic. Nothing. Don't think Manhattan has ever been this quiet. This is Eva Acosta, urban spelunker. Day two inside the city that never sleeps. Last night was pretty freaky, but today's a whole different story. I mean, it's cold as hell, but I've never seen the city look so amazingly peaceful and majestic. The sky is ice blue, and everything is covered with snow. There are huge icicles hanging off the trees. It's like a picture-perfect winter wonderland. I went by the zoo, and it looks like someone let some of the animals go. I wonder if anyone's feeding the ones still there. What the hell is that? Is that the National Guard? What are they doing? There are prisoners in chains being dragged behind trucks. Oh, shit. They see me. Eva Acosta, urban spelunker. Day three. Yesterday, some assholes shot at me. Soldiers. National Guard, maybe. I don't know who they thought I was. Anyway, I'm in Midtown today, not far from the Empire State Building, in front of Abel's department store. My papa used to bring me here when I was little to watch the Thanksgiving Day parade. There's a parade today, but I don't like the looks of it. Guys wearing gas masks and big tanks on their back are leading a group of people into a circle. Some of them are crying. I'm afraid to get any closer because I don't know what they're doing. Maybe I should take some pictures. Oh my God. They're burning them. Oh my God. This is Eva Acosta, urban spelunker, and I gotta get out of the city. It's like, I don't know, people are going crazy. I'm at Abel's, and there aren't any shoppers, just looters. The windows are all broken, and people are just taking what they want. They're laughing, they're screaming, they're fighting over shit. Where are the cops? Where's anybody in charge? always thought I was some kind of anarchist. Flipping off the man, fighting the status quo. I camped out in Zuccotti Park for Occupy Wall Street. I protested the G7 summit, but this is just sad. There's a woman on the street and she's bleeding and she's crying and no one is helping her. And I can't either, because if those looters see me, I don't know what they'll do to me. This is Eva Acosta, and I can't find a way out of this fucking city. I'm almost out of food, and I don't know what to do. There's a whole lot of desperate people camped out in the train yards, but I think a lot of them are sick. There's no way out through the Lincoln Tunnel. There's no way across any of the bridges. There's no way out anywhere. Getting in was easy. They're not watching for people trying to get in. Who'd be stupid enough to want in? But getting out? Oh, shit. I hope I'm not getting sick. I think I better head for the train yards. I don't know where else to go. At least there's safety in numbers there. If someone finds this recording, I'm hoping you can get a message to my parents in Teaneck, New Jersey. Isabel and Ramon Acosta. Tell them Eva loves them. Tell them. I'm sorry.
Now, this city needs a hero. And I will give them that hero. I have always known that it was my destiny to someday be Manhattan's last defender of truth and of justice. And now is my time. It is time for me to don my mask and my cape and to go forth into the streets and to punish the wicked and to defend the innocent. It took the dollar flu, the so-called green poison, to trigger my latent powers. I became indestructible. I had become the living symbol of this city, and I have sworn to protect it. Rikers, the LMB, the strange men with the flamethrowers, I fought them all in the name of justice. I made myself a costume. I took Kevlar from them, and I stitched together, and I made a mask and a cape. The cape was not very good in a fight, though, so I got rid of that after a while. But I always took the fight to the enemy. I stopped them from attacking the innocents, dropping down on them from rooftops, preventing them from preying on the weak. And the Riker who tried to follow me back to my apartment, I am sure that I lost him before he... Wait, what was that noise? I'll be back in a minute. It's been a long time, my friend. A long time since I told you about my adventures, my duty to the city, even. You see, I was attacked by a great many of those escaped prisoners, but I fought them. And even though I was outnumbered, I escaped through the window. I haven't been back since. It's too dangerous. All my notes, all my gadgets, all my tools of justice must remain behind. But I will find a new lair. And I will plot my revenge. And when the time comes, I will reemerge once again and show them the power of justice.
I am Vitaly Chernenko, physician and virologist. I live in Novosibirsk, in Russia. I will record this journal to document the events in New York City after what they call the dollar flu outbreak. I am fortunate to be in New York now, as I am to speak at Sinai Hospital Medical Conference. I hope to be of some use in this crisis. I have, how does one say it, mixed feelings. One does not wish others to suffer. But for virologists, it is also excellent opportunity to learn. The first does not cancel out the second. I should add, English is not my best language, but more people speak it here than Russian, so I will use it.
My talk at the conference has been postponed, as is the conference itself. This is not a surprise. The Russian consulate has called me in. I'm to stay here in the consulate building until the crisis has passed. It's very comfortable. More comfortable than my hotel, in fact, but here one feels a little bit like a prisoner. Am I not more useful to help with the study of green poison? This is what they are calling the virus. If I can work with others? It feels like the bad old days. At least I still have my phone and internet. I will try to stay up on how things develop. Perhaps I can be of help from here. This is all very frustrating. I have a colleague in New York, Dr. Amherst Gordon. He was at Vector for 1 year exchange years ago. Productive time. He was very interested in my work, taking a dangerous virus, Ebola, say, and make small changes to the genome to make the virus less deadly but also more fertile. In the end, a harmless version will win out over harmful one. That is the idea. At the time, it was theory. Now, maybe it is possible using computer and modified 3D printer. I want to speak to Dr. Amherst and see what he thinks. I have called him, but he has not yet answered. I am troubled by the news. The DCD says the virus may be smallpox, but the live smallpox virus is kept in just two places in the world, DCD and Vector in Siberia, where I work. It is very, very hard to access if one does not have the proper security clearance. If this is true, the one behind this may have the connection to DCD or Vector. They may even be known to me. It is disturbing. Still, no answer from Dr. Amherst. I am concerned for his health. I want to go to his home to make sure he is safe, but I am not permitted to leave consulate. I am too vital to Russian interests. So they tell me. Пожалуйста. Watching and reading the news, I am now convinced that the virus is not smallpox, but rather modified virus based on smallpox. Why? Because the symptoms are similar, but... Tweaked. Faster transmission. More lethal. Optimized. This is what I was trying to defend against. Modified viruses weaponized for terrorism. I remember having long talks with Dr. Amherst about it. The consul will not allow me to contact the DCD and share what I know. They say soon we are leaving the United States. That I am so close to being able to help, yet so far makes me angry. I'm terribly sad. I still have heard nothing from Dr. Amherst. I fear the worst. I am so furious. They left me. They left me. For weeks, I did as I was told. I came to consulate. I did not contact DCD. I stayed hidden while an epidemic raged outside. And I might know better than anyone what is really going on. I hid so well, it seems, that they forgot to tell me of the evacuation. They left. This is a wonderful English phrase. In the dead of the night. I have no words. And now I'm here, in the city, under martial law, with no protection. There is only one benefit to this. Now there is no one to tell me I cannot contact DCD and offer my help, or find Dr. Amherst. Now I am free. I hope it is not too late. Outside is worse than I expected. Before I thought this was a crisis to get through, then rebuild. Now, I'm not so sure. I want to go to Dr. Amherst's home to see if he's alive, but I do not think it is safe to do this. The streets seem dangerous. There are almost no police. This is not the New York I remember. It is wiser to stay in consulate for now, I think. At least here, the internet sometimes works. I have alerted the Russian embassy in Washington to my presence. They say they will come for me when blockade is lifted. Until then, I wait.
Hello? Sylvia.
I've been waiting all day for you to call. I've got someone here who's been dying to talk to you. Ricky? Is that you? What the hell is wrong with you, boy? Calling this young lady in the middle of the night? I raised you better than that.
Yeah, it's Rick. Hello? Who's there?
You like that, huh? Having someone call you at 4 o'clock in the morning?
Hey, this is Allie from 89.8, your home for the best music. Am I talking to Naomi?
Yes.
How old are you, Naomi?
I'm 9.
Well, Naomi, you are a very lucky little girl, because if you can answer one question, you're going to be a finalist for a chance to see the Nutcracker at the Lincoln Center.
Yay!
Now listen carefully. Can you tell me who wrote this song?
It's Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. My grandma taught me that.
You've got a very smart grandma, and you're a very smart girl, because you're now entered to win those tickets. Keep listening, and you'll find out if you won real soon.
Okay, bye. Hello, this is Naomi.
Hi again, Naomi. This is Allie from 89.8 again. And I have some good news for you.
What?
Princess, you are going to see the Nutcracker at the Lincoln Center.
Grandma, we won! We won!
So, who are you going to take with you?
My grandma.
Well, you tell Grandma to make sure you have a great time, okay?
Okay.
Now, put your grandma on the line so we can get her those tickets for you.
Okay, Grandma!
911, what's your emergency? Nah, just kidding. It's me, Jen. I can't answer right now, but leave a message and I'll call you back. Peace.
Hi, Jen. It's me, your husband, remember? I've been thinking a lot lately with everything that's happened, and it just occurred to me how much I miss you. I close my eyes and I can still see you walking down the aisle in that tight white dress. My God, what a body. You used to drive me crazy. Can't believe how young we were. And stupid.
911, what's your emergency? Nah, just kidding. It's me, Jen. I can't answer right now, but leave a message and I'll call you back. Peace.
Hi, it's me again. There's something I wanted you to hear. Listen. It's birds, Jen. After 9 years behind bars, I can't tell you how refreshing that is. Ah, I've got to go now. I got some last-minute Christmas shopping to do. But don't worry. You'll see a lot more of me soon. Remember how I used to say even prison couldn't keep us apart? Oh, and I ran into your boyfriend. He says hi. Peace.
What's he doing now?
He's going into a jewelry store.
Oh my God. You know what this means?
It doesn't mean anything.
No grown man goes into a jewelry store at 11 a.m. on a Wednesday.
He's not the affair type, Alex.
Then why the hell are you following him? Hey, Jay. Guess who got seats to the game tonight?
You got tickets?
Yeah, Lamar couldn't go, so I was like, who do I know who's a giant hoops fan?
I'm actually not feeling that well.
Are you sure? Look out your window.
What the? Is that you in the limo?
So how about it? You feeling better yet?
Mom, it's Renee. And I hope you get this message. I'm okay. But I can't get out of Manhattan, and everyone's getting sick. I had to have a couple of drinks to get up the nerve to call you. There's something I wanted to tell you in person, but now I don't know if, I'm gay, Mom. I've always been gay. It's why I came to New York, and Julie isn't my roommate, Mom. Well, she is, but, yeah. I hope you're okay, Mom, and I hope you're okay about this, and that you don't hate me, and that you're okay. I love you, Mom. I love you. Renee, it's your mother. I got your message, and... I know, honey. I've known for a long time, and it's okay. Nothing you could do could stop me from loving you. But Renee, I've seen the news. I'm so worried about you right now. What I need you to do is to be strong for you and Julie. Stay safe and look after each other. I love you, Renee. Call me when you get this.